Elgato has just announced an awesome, incredibly helpful product for streamers and content creators that isn't a capture card. I've been using the Elgato Stream Deck for about a month or so now as a beta tester, so I wanted to go ahead and review it for you. I will have a few tutorials for setting up the Stream Deck for a few different streaming and other kinds of scenarios, as well as a more advanced video on how I've adapted it for my full production workflow coming very shortly, so be sure you're subscribed to see those. I'm Epos Vox, here to make tech easier and more fun, and today we are taking a look at the Elgato Stream Deck, a customizable macro keypad with backlit digital screens behind every key so that you can customize them in the software. I've been wanting something like this in place of my big CP48 macro keypad and second keyboard for a long time, as I got really tired of printing out and cutting paper key labels. Before I dig into the review of the product itself, which is great by the way, I want to briefly talk about why you may or may not need this. Macro keypads are super useful in streaming and production environments. Launching applications, sending automatic messages, switching scenes in your live stream, there's huge productivity and convenience benefits for having dedicated buttons to completing actions that you'd otherwise need to click around a lot for. This is especially key, no pun intended, if you're streaming live. Clicking around in menus or tools while trying to chat with your viewers and play a game leads to a not very polished or professional streaming experience. Instead, just quickly tapping a button off camera to switch scenes, tweet your stream, or show a GIF or a meme looks very nice to the viewers. I've gotten asked quite a few times how I'm doing all this when it looks like I'm still playing my game. And if you really want to dig into advanced settings, this is quite useful for regularly completed actions in other programs. For example, I use it in my Adobe Production Suite, or for launching email, and so on. I've used a few products in this category before. I have a Genovation Control Pad CP48, a Shuttle Pro V2, and an entire second keyboard programmed for macros sitting on my desk at one time. So how does the Elgato Stream Deck compare? It's actually quite nice, but has some light limitations. The software is pretty simple to set up. You have a live view of the icons and can add in functionality from their Game Capture HD software, Tippy Stream Alerts, OBS Studio, Twitter, Twitch, or you can set up your own custom hotkeys and executions. You can add your own icons to every button, which is a lot of fun to set up, and set them up quite simply. You can also create folders of shortcuts and expand capabilities by having nested sets of shortcuts. For example, I have dedicated folders for shortcuts for Adobe Premiere, Photoshop, Audition, and then a folder for shortcuts that I use during my live stream. I'll have dedicated tutorials for all of this on my channel very shortly. You can do some neat stuff with this device, though you don't have complete control. You can program it to do what the software allows, so certain key combinations may or may not work, or you might not have quite as strong integration into your program as you would OBS or their game capture software. But with a little auto hotkey magic and crazy hotkey programming, you can do quite a lot. Overall, the Stream Deck has been a great addition to my production workflow. When I first started testing it, I was only using it for my Adobe production apps, but now that I'm streaming 3 days a week on Twitch, it's been a lifesaver on that front as well. The Elgato Stream Deck will be available shortly, and I hope many of you will be able to make use of it. Hit the like button if you enjoyed my review, subscribe for more awesome tech videos and upcoming Stream Deck tutorials, and I will see you next time.